Hey everyone, I have a couple of really big announcements today. One of those is that we are making changes to which Good and Beautiful products are free. We know that this affects so many of you, so I need to tell you briefly about the Good and the Beautiful story so you understand why we are making these changes. For those of you who don't know, I was a singer-songwriter before I started The Good and the Beautiful. Around 12 years ago, it was time for me to re-sign a 3-album contract with my record label. I went to a meeting about the contract. It was in this big high-rise building, and I was sitting there listening as they outlined my obligations to do CD signings, radio shows, TV shows, interviews, and then they gave me the contract to take home and to look over. My CDs had never been selling better. I had won awards recently for my music. I was traveling all over the world. It was incredible. But something very unexpected happened to me when I walked out of that building that day. I remember going through that glass revolving door and looking across the street, and something struck my heart with such a powerful force. It was a gardener. He was maybe in his 40s, and he was just working humbly in a huge, beautiful flower bed. And I just stopped and stood there watching him. The beautiful blue sky was arched above him. His hands were reaching down into the soil, and the flowers around him were just nodding in the breeze. And he seemed so happy, so peaceful. His life seemed so simple. And my soul just cried out, I want to be that gardener. I want that kind of life. I looked at the record label contract I held, and I knew at that moment I wouldn't sign it. I was done. I had recently realized that I needed to homeschool and decided right then and there that I was done traveling the world and signing CDs and being on radio shows. I was going to lead a slow and simple and peaceful life like that gardener. And that's what I did at first. It quickly became apparent to me in my new life as a homeschool mom that it was really hard to find a language arts curriculum, even from Christian homeschool companies, that incorporated wholesome books. I started a deep and dedicated study of children's literature. It was fascinating to me how it has changed over time and how books today are undermining family unity and high moral character. I started reviewing books for my own children and decided to release the Good and Beautiful book list to my music fans. The next thing that became apparent to me as a homeschool mom were two things. They went hand in hand. First was that language arts had the potential, I knew, to be a powerful, life-changing, character-building, absolutely beautiful experience. But it wasn't. And so I started scouring the world to try to find a language arts curriculum that was just what I was looking for, that would work for us. And I think I probably bought and studied about every homeschool language arts curriculum I could. But they all fell short for my family for some reason or other. Sometimes I would find beauty in a curriculum, but it wasn't academically strong. Or I found one that was academically strong, but it didn't incorporate God or family or nature or good literature. And then the second thing was the number of courses I had to use to teach language arts. For each child, I had a writing course, a grammar course, a spelling course, a literature course, and that was on top of math and science and history that I needed to teach, and I also needed to be teaching geography and art. I'm sure most of you can relate to this. So, long story short, I created my own language arts curriculum for my children that incorporated reading and phonics, writing, spelling, literature, geography, and art into one course. Even though I had a music career, I had majored in English during college. I had a passion for good literature and experience with it. I had been an editor for a magazine, a professional writer, and even managed a technical writing department. Language arts was my thing. It was my passion. I had never had any intention of selling the curriculum. It was only for my kids. My husband had an amazing job, and the thought of having a curriculum company literally did not cross my mind as I created my curriculum. But then one of my music fans emailed me, and I didn't know her, and she said that she had heard that I homeschooled and wondered if I could give her some advice because she had felt like she was supposed to homeschool, but she didn't feel like she could do it anymore. and she didn't feel the joy in it. And I just experienced that with myself. And she was overwhelmed. And I said, hey, I created this curriculum for my kids because of those same things. And it's just open and go, no prep. It's filled with beauty. We connect art and geography to language arts and all this. I said, you should try it. And she did. And she ended up telling me a little later that it changed her homeschool. And then this same thing happened with the second woman who contacted me. And I said, try this curriculum. And then when she told me as well that it changed their homeschool, that is when I had the idea of offering this curriculum to others. Because I had done the work of creating it and it was helping people. So I thought, I'll just put it on my music website and sell it. So in order to do that, it needed to be solid. So I rewrote the curriculum and brought in reading specialists and professional editors and reviewers to help. And then the day came that I released the curriculum. I sent an email out to my music list and I announced it. It was for sale. I had two levels of language arts at that time, and I was selling the language arts courses, I think, for around $100. Because I had looked around and at comparable programs, and some of them were $200, $300, so it sounded fair to me. I sent the email, and then I suddenly felt terrible. I couldn't shake this terrible feeling that I had. So I got down on my knees, and I prayed, and I said, what is going on? And I had such a strong impression come into my mind that God had helped me create this curriculum because he wanted it to bless homeschool families, not for my own business. I felt at that moment, I knew at that moment that the curriculum was supposed to be free. It was kind of a frightening feeling. I had spent a lot of time on this, a lot. And we had used the savings we had from my music money to create this curriculum. It was a lot of money. And I had to tell my husband, actually, I think we should just give this product out for free. I did need to create future levels of language arts too. So I prayed and I asked God, if I give this all away for free, how will I ever create anything else? And I felt impressed in my mind that I had also created handwriting books. I could sell downloads of those and use that money to create more language arts courses. And so the same day that I sent the email out to say, this is available for like $100. I sent an email back and said, never mind, it's actually free. So I thought of that peaceful gardener. It was actually a relief to me. And I said to myself, okay, great. The curriculum is out there. People can use it and access it and download it. I don't want a business anyway. I just hope the curriculum blesses people. I didn't really expect the response that we got from the curriculum. I did not market it in any way, but through word of mouth, it spread and people were loving it. But they said, these like 300-page color course books are actually quite expensive to get printed. And that worried me because I was also getting heartfelt emails from people telling me how much they loved the curriculum and how much it was changing them and their children. I thought, oh, it is expensive to print, but if I buy it in bulk, I can offer it for much less than people can get it printed for themselves and make it affordable. So I ordered some physical books to sell. And I will never forget the day that a semi-truck pulled up to my house and dropped off a big wooden shrink wrap pallet of books, of course books, into the middle of my driveway. I had ordered like thousands of CDs before, but they're so small. It just like comes in a few boxes, but there is like this massive pallet in my driveway. I didn't know what I was gonna do with it. Where in the world am I gonna put all these course books? And I thought, I'm never gonna sell all these. What have I done? And I actually felt so much anxiety over that one pallet of books that I told myself, when these books are gone, I will not buy anymore. Well, I did. Because I heard so much about how the curriculum is helping people and because God just continued to push me along in the journey. And I started hiring people all along thinking, I'm not really doing a business. I really don't want a business. It really hadn't hit me yet that I had a business to run. I was just trying to help homeschool moms. Eventually, my entire garage and basement was full of products and I had 15 employees working in my house each day. Semi-trucks were delivering 15 to 20 pallets of curriculum at a time to our house, and they would line the sidewalk going down the street with pallets before we could get all of them carried down into the basement. For the first 2 to 3 years after releasing the curriculum, I had no marketing team at all. I posted maybe once a month on Facebook. I didn't have an Instagram account. I didn't attend conventions. After all, I was not doing a business. So eventually we had to move to a warehouse. And I think my neighbors were very glad about that. The day came that we moved into the warehouse. The moment finally came then that I realized I have a business. And I looked around and people were there assembling pallet racks, going up high, and a forklift was moving pallets around. Dozens of people were working, and I ran into the bathroom and I just started crying. I didn't want to do this. I just wanted to be that gardener. This was all so stressful. Now I had a 4-year warehouse lease signed and there was a forklift moving curriculum around. I had no desire to have a warehouse or a forklift. And as I was crying in that bathroom, I thought, how can I get out of this? I was seriously about to go out and tell everyone to just go home because I was just going to shut it all down. I really was. But God stopped me. He placed in my mind all of these children. Your precious children. And as these children flashed before my eyes, I could feel of their worth to our Heavenly Father. And I knew that the good and the beautiful was doing an important work. And I rolled up my sleeves and I walked out of the bathroom with my tear-stained face and I went to work. So we now have over 140 employees and hundreds of thousands of families across the world use the curriculum. Our language arts courses are the most searched for homeschool language arts program on the internet, more than any other homeschool curriculum. But I needed to tell you this story to help you understand our announcement today. Our announcement. So first, the good and the beautiful is building schools in Africa. We have built 2 schools that are now up and running in Uganda. And we are building 3 more schools in Uganda as well. This means a lot to me. And we have a school being built in Ghana as well. I never started this company to make money for myself. I started it to do good in the world. So I also want to do good with the profits the company makes. A little down the road in another video, I am very excited to share more about these schools and what we're doing and how you can get involved. But I wanted you to know what we are doing with our money because you are all contributing towards these schools and it is incredible. The other thing you're contributing to is the creation of new curriculum that is blessing the lives of children and families around the world, including yours, we hope. This leads me to the second big announcement I have. The new language arts courses that we created are above and beyond anything we have created before. It has taken a lot of money to create them, a lot of collaboration, and a lot of work, and we are so very excited about them. So my team found ourselves asking, can we and should we still give this out for free? We really need a new building that we don't have money for. So much money and time went into this project. It is mind-boggling. And I found myself thinking, we sell the products for such a little amount, maybe we just don't need to offer it for free anymore with these new versions. They are just at a totally different level and a much bigger expense to create than our original courses. So while thinking about this, I had some of the biggest challenges that have ever come my way with The Good and the Beautiful come to head. And one night I could not sleep. And you have all been at this place in your life, so you know what I mean. I was on the verge of having panic attacks all through the night because of this incredible stress. And it was 5:30 in the morning. I was exhausted, but I couldn't sleep. So I just decided to get up. And I picked up my phone as I lay in bed to read my emails, which I don't normally do and I don't suggest doing first thing in the morning. And I found out that on top of everything else, we had this major problem with a printing job that was going to cost us all of this money. And then a video message popped up and it was a key member of our team having to quit right away for an important but unexpected family reason. And I had no idea how we were gonna replace her. It was all just too much. And it was for years, too much of having to persist and to be brave and to be strong and to deal with so many pressures. So I got up and I was walking into my closet to get my shoes. It was dark and I was like, I'm done. I just really can't do this a moment longer. And I don't even care how great these new language arts courses are. I'm done. I don't even want to release them. And I said to God, see God, This is why I just wanted a simple life. This is why I wanted to be that gardener. And instantly into my mind came these words, I have made you a gardener. And it's like I saw, I could envision in my mind, a map of the world with hundreds of thousands of points of light. All the children that would wake up that day and do the Good and the Beautiful curriculum and come closer to God and learn to discern and seek out what is good and beautiful in life and in learning and in literature. I had just pictured myself gardening on this small garden plot. That's where I wanted to be. That's where I thought I would be happy. God had pictured something much more. There were so many times that I didn't feel like I could do the Good and the Beautiful a second longer, but I hung on every time, trusting God. This story is your story too. As a homeschool parent, you will have so many times that you don't feel like you can homeschool a second longer, but you continue to do it. And you are a gardener. You feel that beating heat on the sun on your back during the hot days. You see weeds popping up and you just continue to pull them out. You labor so diligently as you continue to nurture your precious, precious sprouts, and they will grow into beautiful trees that will bear amazing fruit. And your children will go on to plant seeds, and it will go on and on because of the work you are doing. And that is why I am excited to make this second announcement today. As of right now, February 2022, our levels 1 through 5 math and language arts downloads are free. So the question is, will they continue to be free with our new language arts version? Yes, we are going to keep them free, but we are also going to make our K-8 math and language arts courses downloads free starting June 1st, 2022. I was reminded that the whole reason that God led me to create and share this curriculum was to help others, and I never want to lose sight of that. And I hope you will not lose sight of the work you are doing in homeschooling. God will lead you, and He has in mind for you and your children much more than you do. Let Him lead as you plant those seeds. As it says in Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy paths.